What's up, guys? It's Gino. Welcome back to the LBA playoffs. This is actually the second round of the LBA playoffs, and I'm facing my good friend Shadow Chew, owner of the Tokyo Raichus. He finished 14-6 on the season and ended up with the number 2 seed in the playoffs. He brought an interesting team of Togetic, Snorlax, Manaphy, Raichu, Mega Altaria, and Weavile. Kind of a sash spammy offense team, kind of offense. But very sash spammy because he recognized I didn't always bring rocks. Well, I ended up bringing Clefable, Entei, Excadrill, Gothitelle, Salamence, and Gyarados. As you guys can see, I didn't bring Thundurus this week because there is a rule that you can only bring one legendary per week in the LBA, and I thought Entei had a slightly better matchup, so, you know, decided to go with that. But anyway, let's go ahead and kick it off. Hopefully we can advance and keep our season alive, because that, you know, would be very, very nice. He ends up issuing the challenges. I lead with Adolescence, which is my Clefable, as he does end up leading with Weavile. I am actually unaware this week, so makes zero difference to me to the fact that he gets up an SD right here, because I can just T-Wave him, and I have no qualms with just Moonblasting him right here. As you guys can see, he is actually SD Poison Jab, but Poison Jab is a roll on 2-hit KOing me after Leftover's recovery, so I can just fire off a Moonlight right here, and the plan is to Moonlight until he gets fully parried, but that just ends up working out for me sooner rather than later, and I can just knock him out with a Moonblast. So, you know, I end up coming out of the lead matchup relatively unscathed. I'm up 6-5, and I'm in a very, very good position. So he ends up going out into Manaphy right here and makes a pretty neat double switch out into Playoff Chew, which is his Raichu, as I go straight out into apparently, which is my Gothitelle, and right here he does go for the Nasty Plot, and we're gonna see that he's actually a really, really cool set right here, as I go for the Psychic, and I do a lot of damage, but I don't actually knock him out. Like, I at first thought he was Sash, but he's not, but I knock him into Salac range, which is really unfortunate, and I'm just gonna have to sack Gyarados right here, because I have nothing for a plus 2 Raichu, and, like, I have nothing that switches in on it. I just need a way to revenge it, and I go to Entei, and, named after, and these are all named after songs on J. Cole's 14 Forest Hills Drive, but he ends up going for the Endure right here, as I just click E-Speed, which is fine, because, like, oh boy, I did damage, so much damage, and, he recognized that I will just be able to knock him out in E-Speed, so I go for another E-Speed right here, actually, which does absolutely zero, and then I click maybe the best fire move in the game, which is Sacred Fire, because of that 50% burn chance, I do end up burning him, which is very nice, as he ends up setting up a screen, but I know he's a Violite based off how well he's taking these hits, so I just pivot out into my Gothitelle right here, because I know I can trick him and stop him from setting up even more screens, and I can stall out his Reflect, which is very, very nice for me, because making sure that he can't have screens up is absolutely beautiful for me, as he just ends up going for the Gleam, which is a little bit unfortunate, and basically prevents me from just spamming T-Wave until he dies, and just stalling him out. So I just end up deciding to go for a Psychic. Either way, Psychic would have 2-hit KO'd, so the Spidev drop does not matter. But as you guys can see, as soon as I knock him out with the Psychic right here, his Reflect does in fact go away. So no screens for him this battle. Very, very nice. He goes into his Raichu, and at this point, I don't really have anything to take this reversal, except for my Gothitelle, and I just end up staying in, because, you know, I was comfortable with sacking it at that point. It had done its job. It had tricked away its specs, so I do end up getting another kill right there, but he actually goes out into Altaria right here, doesn't Mega Evolve, goes for the Hyper Voice to knock me out, and I can just go out into Clefable, because I am unaware, and I can just T-Wave something, and that something is going to be his Yang, which is Snorlax, so fine by me if I can just get another T-Wave off on this thing. No ill intent on trying to get, like, full paras or anything, but it lets Altaria be revenge killed. So I end up going out of role models, and which is Salamence, as he goes for the Rain Dance, which is kind of cool. But there's just, anyway, sorry. I was looking at my team matchup this week, and I was like reading the chat in the UU room, and they said that Home Claws Mints was pretty neat. So your boy went with Home Claws Mints this week. And as you guys can see, there is actually kind of an upside to running Home Claws as a wall breaker, because it hits so much harder. Like Dragon Rush and Iron Tail are both 100% accurate and yield amazing coverage, along with like Fire Blast, which now never misses because of the accuracy boost. So, you know, being able to knock that out is nice. He goes into Altaria. He has to Mega Evolve right here. Because if I knock him out with the Iron Tail or with the Dragon Rush, then he automatically loses, because you have to Mega Evolve if you leave the Pokemon in, and like you have to Mega Evolve before it dies. Anyway, so now it's coming down to his last, which is Manaphy versus four of my Pokemon. He ends up actually revealing a Salac, so he's Tail Glow Salac, and he ends up he ends up getting a good chunk of damage off there with the Surf, which is a crit. Then he's going to crit me again, unfortunately, so a little bit unfortunate, but at this point I can just go into Entei, click E-Speed, and knock him out. I do end up getting a crit right here, but you know, had he not crit me twice, then, you know, I still would be alive with Mints and would have been game. But anyway, very good game, Shadow. Very amazing season. It was really fun to watch you play. Especially like going back through replays and such. But anyway, if you guys did enjoy today's battle, please make sure to leave a like. It really does help show support for the stuff that I'm doing here on the channel. Also, make sure to answer today's comment question of the video, which is, do you guys think we have a realistic possibility of winning the LBA finals? We play D-Train next round, which is actually really interesting because like he records my battles and all that stuff. But, you know, hopefully we can pull out of that. But with that, I urge you guys to subscribe if you guys are enjoying the constant content. And with that, I'll catch you on the flip-flop.